Welcome back to Psychology of the Unknown. If you're into true crime, the paranormal, ghost stories, and psychology, then you're in luck. That's all we do here. So if you want to make sure you don't miss a single video, then invite the subscribe button to go swimming, but then hold its head underwater until it drowns. Then, when the notification bell pulls it out of the water and attempts CPR, drive over them both with your car. Don't forget to let the like button out of your trunk. But before you leave, staple a comment to the back of its head. Today, I'm going to tell you the story of another of my experiences in that old mansion from the 1800s. So let's begin. As I told you in my secret in the basement video, during my first marriage, I lived in an old mansion that was built sometime in the 1800s. At the time this story takes place, we had moved our bedroom to the other side of the kitchen and combined it with our living room, because we decided to turn the other bedroom into my daughter's room for when she came to stay with us on the weekends. The frame to our bed had broken a short time before this, so we placed our mattress and box springs on the floor, pushed into the corner with the foot of the bed pointed towards the door. Along the wall that the head of our bed was against was our green pleather couch. Across from it, along the same wall as the door, was our computer desk, and next to it, in the corner, was our console TV. In between the TV and the couch was the doorway to our bathroom, and through the bathroom, a walk-in closet. Neither had doors separating them. Instead, there was a curtain hanging in the doorway for bathroom privacy. After the incident with the basement and the boy at the end of my bed, I was well on guard most of the time, and constantly got the feeling I was being watched. There were times that I'd walk into the room from the kitchen or from downstairs, and I would feel like there was someone standing in our closet watching. When I'd turn to look, it was empty. I couldn't escape it. There were times when I'd be in the kitchen doing dishes and catch the silhouette of the little boy watching me. It sent chills up my spine, but I knew he meant no harm. From time to time, I would lay in bed at night, half awake, half asleep, with my eyelids heavy but fighting sleep, because I felt like something was watching me from the closet. The closer I would get to sleep, the stronger the feeling was of eyes staring at me. My wife at the time was asleep next to me. When we switched rooms, I switched my side of the bed, because I feel the need to be on the outside closest to the door, no matter the room or who I'm with. It's a primal need which goes back to the masculine desire to protect the opposite sex. It may be a bit misogynistic, but it is what it is. As time went on, the feelings of being watched grew stronger and stronger. There were times when I'd begin to drift off, but I'd see the silhouette of a girl standing in the closet. I knew it was a girl because it looked like it had straight, long hair, and was in something of a dress or a nightgown. Shortly after seeing it, I would drift off to sleep, and the next morning, I would think I had imagined the whole thing. One night, however, I went to bed as usual, but didn't get the feeling of being watched that I usually did. The hairs on my arms and neck didn't stand, and everything was calm. Without the feeling of the watchful eyes staring at me, I managed to fall straight to sleep. I don't remember dreaming that night, but I do remember opening my eyes at 3 a.m. The digital alarm clock sat on the bedside table between the bed and the couch. I was laying on my left side when I woke up, and it took me a moment for my eyes to adjust. But there in the closet stood a young girl. She was no older than 10, with long dark hair, a pale complexion, and wearing a light blue nightgown. She just stood there staring at me, and I couldn't take my wide open eyes off her. It was autumn and the room was cold, but beads of sweat ran down my cheek and forehead. My chest grew still, as I was too unnerved to breathe. When I realized I hadn't taken a breath in some time, I slowly pulled air into my lungs, but as I did, my unconscious physical response was to blink. When my eyelids raised again, the girl had moved. She was no longer in the closet, but instead was standing motionless in the bathroom doorway. My throat involuntarily swallowed from the lump I felt, and my eyes grew wider when I realized she was now closer to me. My eyes grew dry when I realized I hadn't blinked in a few moments. I held my eyes open as long as I could, but couldn't do it anymore, as they were beginning to burn. Then I did it. I closed my eyes, but held them shut far longer than just a blink. When I opened them again, she was standing over me, looking down with a lifeless expression on her face, her hair hanging in her eyes. I remember nothing more after that. The next thing I knew, it was morning, and the night before felt like a bad dream that continued to leave my heart racing. My wife at the time was already awake and getting dressed. I asked her if there was anything else she had failed to mention about the house other than the thing in the basement, to which she told me no. So I told her about the girl, and she asked me to tell her what she looked like. When I described her, she got a puzzled look on her face. She recognized the description I gave. She walked over to a box of photos she kept by her TV and pulled one out. "Did she look like this?" she asked with what seemed like a tremble in her voice as she handed me the picture. "That's her!" I exclaimed. "Who the hell is she?" It turns out the girl in the closet was her best friend growing up, who had died of cancer at just 10 years old. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss a single video. Give us a like, leave a comment below, and please share the video with your family and friends. I've been Shannon, and this has been Psychology of the Unknown.